Hey, it's Lee, and welcome back to my channel. So, once in our life, we meet extraordinary people whose lives inspire us and move us with their presence. So, for this week's Flashback Friday, our episode is called Of Chordoma, Courage, and the Cosmos. So, this September being a Childhood Cancer Awareness Month, I would like to feature two extraordinary people that I know, Jem Sapanta and her son, Aiden Pio, and also raise awareness of this uncommon cancer named Chordoma. So let's begin.
This is my fight song, take back my life song, prove I'm all right song.
Before we talk about Pio, of course, we have to talk about the elephant in the room, which is Chordoma. So what is Chordoma? And since Pio was diagnosed with this rare cancer disease known as Chordoma, I personally didn't want to just do research on this. I need to be careful regarding the subject. So I asked my cousin, a practicing medical oncologist, Kuya Dennis, or Dr. Dennis Sacdalan, to help me with this. So
I'll be introducing my cousin, Kuya Dennis Sacdalan, or Dr. Dennis Sacdalan. So here's a brief background of my cousin. After med school, he took a residency in internal medicine, and he subspecialized in medical oncology, and he is author and co-author on papers on colon and rectal cancer, and he is currently a consultant in PGH and Manila Med. Okay. Hi, Kuya! Hello!
Hi, good evening.
Good evening, Kuya. So, Kuya Dennis is here. Okay, we don't have to be formal, but in some other moment. But the reason why I asked Kuya to do this, because this is already a medical term, and I don't want to give misinformation. So that's why I asked my Kuya. Dennis is a doctor, and he's even an oncologist to do this for me, this interview. So thank you very much, Kuya. Sobrang thank you for this. All right. Okay, so let's go to the first question. Okay, since it's about Chordoma, the first thing is, of course, what is Chordoma? If you can explain it to us, maybe in layman's terms,
yeah, okay. So chordoma is a type of bone tumor. So it's a cancer that originates from the bone. And it's quite rare. So you don't see it that often. There are several types of bone tumors, but this is somehow associated with neural tissue. I don't know if you understand that, but nerve and bone tissue combined, if they form tumors.
Kuya, bakit siya rare?
Well, of all bone tumors, it occurs in around 2-4% of cases, and sometimes it occurs in the brain. So okay. among central nervous system tumors, it's just about 0.2%. Of all of these brain tumors, so that's how rare it is.
Usually, adult ba or kids ang nagkakaroon?
Yeah, usually it's seen in adults, those in the mid 20s to around the pwedeng umabot pa na mga 50s or 60s. But these tumors can also occur in the pediatric age group, those less than 19 years old. But then again, as I said, it's rare, no? So you seldom see this.
Lalo sa kids, mas rare siya. Mm-hmm. So usually, what are the symptoms for this cancer?
It depends on where it actually originates, no? So the most common area where chordomas occur would be in the sacrum or dun sa may pelvis, no? yung parang balakang natin. So if it occurs there, it usually presents as pain, no? And sometimes it can also affect nerves affecting organs in that area. So you could have urinary incontinence and maybe bowel problems. Other areas that chordomas can arise from would be in the brain also. So if it occurs in the brain, usually the presenting symptoms would be yung pagiging cross-eyed or headaches. Sometimes also they can occur along the spine, and so usually pain ang presenting symptom.
The next question is treatment for chordoma. If a person has chordoma, what can we do?
Well, the mainstay of treatment for chordomas is usually surgery, no? So kailangan talagang operahan yan. It's not responsive to medical treatments like chemotherapy, no? So it's really operation ang kailangan dyan, to excise that tumor. And sometimes we do also apply radiotherapy to prevent recurrence of these tumors.
What's radiotherapy?
Radiotherapy is applying high energy beam towards a certain part of the body.
Okay.
So it actually burns tumor cells, so that it will these tiny tumor cells will die and prevent recurrence by killing these cancer cells na hindi natanggal ng surgery. And
Go ahead.
Your question earlier was how can you help? So if you know someone who probably has a bone tumor like chordoma, well, I guess the best advice would be to recommend treatment from a doctor, from a specialist. You can start off with a neurologist or a neurosurgeon or an orthopedic surgeon also. It really depends on where it's coming from. Kasi ang chordomas, it can come from several areas, no? As I mentioned, sa sacrum or sa brain. So depending on where it starts, you have to find out kung sino yung appropriate doctor for that. So kung sa buto, sa spine, or sa sacrum, pwedeng sa ortho. Kung sa brain, maybe a neurosurgeon would be the most appropriate person to approach. No? And usually it's these doctors who will call in a team to help him out. No? Baka may kailangan radiation oncologist na kasama, even a pathologist para basahin yung biopsy to be sure na chordoma nga talaga and to ensure na tama yung ibibigay na treatment.
So actually, I guess that's it for my little interview. So thank you very much, Kuya. Sobrang thank you. Kasi as much as possible, I don't want to give misinformation because this is a very new subject that is very serious. Thank you very much, Kuya, for gracing my vlog.
Okay. When you talk about courage, one of the bravest women that comes to my mind is fellow physician and a wonderful artist named Jen Sapanta. And her very dear genius and talented and accomplished son, Aidan Pio. Jem Pascual Sapanta was a former Wins Events Management bride. She got married to the Noah Calhoun of her life, which is Robbie Sapanta. And of course, Jem is the Allison Nelson or Ally of his life. So if you're familiar with The Notebook, that's actually their love story. It's like that. And truth be told, this husband and wife are the love gurus of my life. Okay. So on May 26, 2016, I receive a inquiry from Jem if I can do an on-the-day wedding for her on December 14, 2016. However, come July 21 of the same year, Jem asked a special request. She asked me if it's okay to move the date a bit earlier. Okay, so she asked me if I can move it on August 21, 2016, because he was going to have palliative treatment, and correct me if I'm wrong, or what I remembered, it he might be also on life support. So who are we to say no, right? This is really something we can't control, and as much as possible, this is the least we can do for Jem and Pio. So Rob and Jem's wedding is one of the most unforgettable weddings that we had in Wins events, especially when me and my team members met Pio. We wanted to do our best for the wedding, especially we wanted Pio to really be the ring bearer, he would feel it. So all throughout the event, you would see how much the moment was worth waiting for both Robbie and Jem. As you can see, they're really so sweet, they were holding hands. And at the end of the event, we actually ended on a high note with the very game friends of the couple. As in, super game sila, talagang walang killjoy sa kanila. They were really game to do it. However, the laughter was a little dialed down because of the touching and the poignant speeches done by Miss Betty Zapanta, the mother of the groom, Dr. Testitko, mother of the bride, and of course, Aiden Pio Pascual Zapanta, or Pio himself, when he did his speech. I remember when he said, "Babe, take care of my mom. I love you." So he actually calls Robbie Babe, because that's what Jem calls Robbie Babe. So parang nasanay din si PNL to call Robbie Babe then. So actually I remembered since I was hosting it, ang hirap makarecuperate nung sa moment na yun. Actually I was really teary-eyed by that time kasi during that time we had our fear that Pio nga will be in life support, baka mag life support na siya, and I remember that. That's why I imagine there was a double meaning of his words. So kaya medyo syempre na-touch sobra kami. They embody courage because kasi ang tibay-tibay talaga ni Jem. I mean, I've never met a mother who would really do everything for her son, especially if, considering that P has a very rare disease, a cancer disease for this one. So yun lang. So for me, they never took anything for granted. They made their most of their lives until today. You would see them really sharing their experiences. If you're a friend of Jem and also of a follower of Pio's Facebook page, you would really be inspired. Because how much they love, they take everything really courageously, being strong every day. So, and not just strong, but they're also very cheerful for regarding this as well. They're very courageous kasi nga, having this very rare sickness, Jem and Pio never took anything for granted. They stood fast and never gave up on life. And they do their best to live their lives. To say that Pio loves astronomy is an understatement. Okay, in fact, he so loves it that he is currently a newbie at this YouTube university. So aside from our common love for Star Wars, Pio, like me when I was young, although I still dream of it, dreams of being an astronaut someday. As he waits to reach those heavenly bodies, he currently inspires us with his paintings of these celestial bodies. Pio's works have been in several exhibits already. The one where we participated in was the exhibit after the wedding called Per Aspera Ad Astra. Translated into English, it's True Hardships to the Stars, which was held from October 22 to November 8 in 2016. At Prison Gallery, Makati City. The exhibit was to help with his proton beam treatment, and this was made possible through the generosity of Ms. Gold Tantoco, president of Prism Gallery, and the very accommodating and cool admin of the gallery, namely Ms. Leia Gakud, as well as Ms. Razel Ouine. I remember meeting the gracious people of the Prism Gallery, helping Pio and his family regarding this. In fact, he had a second art exhibit there, which was named Dum Spiro Spero, translated to English to be While I Breathe, I Hope. This was held the following year on May 22, June 3, 27. Although prior to these exhibits, he already had a little exhibit already as a child earlier. But this came after the wedding, actually. So he also has done fundraising activities. There are times we auction his artworks. We did it once with a dinner something at this auction. And then, as mentioned, he has done fundraising and charity work. So one of them I actually joined. It was in PGH, where we went to the pediatric cancer ward. So we were with children, and we were with different people also. And then also there were cosplayers, and we were given food, and we were talking, reaching out to these kids. And then also during the pandemic, Pio helped also PGH in a way that Jem and Pio raised funds, selling his artworks as well to help PGH, the PGH frontliners, by giving them food, raising some money for to help them in any which way they can. They also promoted help promote this card making for the frontliners there. So up until now, P is actually still painting. Okay, he was supposed to have an online exhibit, but something happened, so it was postponed for now. And so there, so he's really truly inspiring. For me, knowing Jem and Pio and his works are inspiring. I hope this short video, you two are inspired with the courage of these two individuals who remain optimistic despite the difficulties they encountered. Also, I hope in my own way I was able to contribute to help raise awareness of children and families affected with childhood cancers like Chordoma, and to emphasize the importance of supporting research in these families and foundations, especially regarding these devastating conditions. Okay. I also like to encourage you to like, follow, and subscribe the Facebook page, of course, of Pio. Any ways to help Pio and kids like him. So first, of course, please, as mentioned, please like and subscribe Pio's personal blog or Facebook page, which is Aiden Pio's Fight with Uncommon. You can help him financially. You can commission him to do artworks for you. If not, at least if you'd like, you can check their special merch. Okay, they have this shop in that page where you can buy like Bravelets by Pio. Neurons, Be Brave, Tote Bag, Dun Spero, and or Per Aspera Ad Astra Postcards, Aphrodite Tote Bag, and many more. Okay, and if you just like and follow his Facebook page, you can view the shop. There's more there. There's more merch there. I will place the link below. Also, if you follow his Facebook page, you would also gain awareness regarding Chordoma, also be inspired of how Jem and her family is really an inspirational force to reckon with, because Jem and Pia post a beautiful post basically in Facebook. Follows other similar pages and website like that of the Chordoma Foundation, that would be good. Okay, and just help whichever you can to raise awareness regarding Chordoma, that would be great. Okay, so until the next Flashback Friday episode, carpe diem, and thank you for joining me today.